Well, it's one thing to say giving back is in your blood, but our next guest is taking the phrase quite literally. Jean-Pierre Van Heerden is one of the lucky New Zealanders who can say he's survived COVID-19. And now he's donating his plasma to help other COVID-19 patients have an easier time. And by the way, plasma treatment is by no means a new concept. It has been used since the 1920s and in recent years used against SARS, H1N1, influenza and other viruses. Now, Jean-Pierre joins us now live from the Blood Donor Centre in Epsom. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Yeah, really good, thank you. And I'd really like to start with hearing your COVID-19 story. So if you could, just describe to us what that experience was like with the virus and the physical effects that it had on you.
Yeah, it was an awful experience. I don't wish it upon anybody. I guess at the start it felt like it was flu, but you know, a couple of days later it was a lot worse, and from there things got really scary. You just don't know where it's going to end up, or if you're going to come out of hospital and be one of those that survives it. So a lot of things going through your head, obviously fearing for your life, and thinking about your family and just wanting to get back home, I guess.
And how long did it take for you to recover from the virus?
It was close in a month, because you have to be symptom-free. So, it's easily that, I guess. Mm-hmm. For cases that are more serious, there was probably cases that are more serious than mine, and maybe recovery was longer. But I lost a month of my life recovering from coronavirus.
Now, I'm also interested in how having the virus impacted your mental well-being. Did you feel judged? Were you reluctant to tell people that you had the virus and that you'd recovered?
No, I wouldn't say I felt judged, and I wasn't reluctant to tell people. What helped me mentally was, people supporting me, obviously, friends, family, colleagues, my faith.
That's okay. First time on telly, I can totally understand that. Now, tell me, how did you learn about how plasma helps the body fight COVID-19?
I received a call from NZ Blood about a week and a half ago, and the gentleman explained to me how it all works and how I can help fellow Kiwis. And, once I'd had a better understanding of it, I was all in favour of helping out. I don't like to see people suffer, so if there's something I can do to help them, why not?
So because you won't be able to see this, but I'm just going to run a little graphic so that for those at home who are watching actually understand how plasma helps fight the virus. And this is an explainer that was sent to us by the New Zealand Blood Service. Now, plasma is collected from people who have fully recovered and pose no risk of infecting others. This is called convalescent plasma and contains antibodies to the infection they've recovered from. It is these antibodies that can help others to fight off the infection. So once you learnt that, no hesitation, right, for you to donate your plasma?
No hesitation at all. I have given blood before, not often, because the last time I'd given blood I passed out.
So well,
I was a bit nervous,
stuff.
But I... No, on this occasion, obviously with what's going on, it's important that I help. So there was no hesitation on my part.
So is there any criteria apart from having recovered from COVID-19?
I wouldn't know all of it, but I guess having recovered is probably one of the biggest things I'd look at or consider, I guess.
Now, we're into level two and there's almost a feeling of, we've got this now. Maybe we're even a little bit complacent with some of our behaviour. Given your experience of having the virus, what would you say to Kiwis?
Look, I would still take this serious, given what we've seen around the world. I was one of those people that didn't travel. People in my close circles didn't have coronavirus. And when I received my test results and they were positive, it really freaked me out. So this spreads easily, and we still need to be careful. So, I know we need to get the country moving again, and, the economy's got to recover from what we've now been through. But we still need to be mindful of the fact that this virus is deadly and it's serious.
Okay, you're at the Blood Service Centre in Epsom, so you're going to be donating your plasma today?
Correct, later this morning.
And how long does that process take?
I believe 45 minutes to an hour.
Okay, well, good luck with that. And given your last experience, I hope
I'm really hoping I don't pass out.
Yeah. Really appreciate your time this morning and sharing your story as well, Jean-Pierre Van Heerden.
That's beautiful. Yeah. I'm really hoping I don't pass out.
Yeah.
And then laughing.
Yeah.
I think that's gallows humour, isn't it?
That'd be great. So the New Zealand Blood Service wants to reassure us that the blood banks are still a safe place to visit and that they still need our blood. Now they need.
And you won't pass out.
Yeah, well, you might. But 3,500 donations every week to be able to meet the demand at the New Zealand Blood Service.